Good morning, my friends.
Good morning.
And welcome to our Eucharistic celebration today. So let us begin. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Brothers and sisters, let us acknowledge our sins and so prepare ourselves to celebrate these sacred mysteries. I confess to Almighty God and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done, in what I have failed to do. To my most grievous fault. Therefore, I ask the Blessed Mary of the Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Let us pray. O God, who open wide the gates of the heavenly kingdom to those reborn of water and the Holy Spirit, pour out on your servants an increase of the grace you have bestowed, that having been purged of all sins, they may lack nothing that in your kindness you have promised. To our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the Acts of the Apostles. Stephen said to the people, the elders and the scribes, "You stiff-necked people, uncircumcised in heart and ears, you always oppose the Holy Spirit. You are just like your ancestors. Which of the prophets did your ancestors not persecute? They put to death those who foretold the coming of the righteous one, whose betrayers and murderers you have now become. You received the law as transmitted by angels, but you did not observe it." When they heard this, they were infuriated, and they ground their teeth at him. But Stephen, filled with the Holy Spirit, looked up intently to heaven and saw the glory of God and Jesus standing at the right hand of God. And Stephen said, "Behold, I see the heavens opened, and the Son of Man standing at the right hand of God." But they cried out in a loud voice, covered their ears, and rushed upon him together. They threw him out of the city and began to stone him. The witnesses laid down their cloaks at the feet of a young man named Saul. As they were stoning Stephen, he called out, "Lord Jesus, receive my spirit." Then he fell to his knees and cried out in a loud voice, "Lord, do not hold this sin against them." And when he said this, he fell asleep. Now Saul was consenting to his execution. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to
God. Into your hands, O Lord, I commend my spirit.
Into your hands, O Lord, I commend my spirit.
Be my rock of refuge, a stronghold to give me safety. You are my rock and my fortress. For your name's sake, you will lead and guide me. Into your hands, O Lord, I commend my spirit. Into your hands, I commend my spirit. You will redeem me, O Lord, O faithful God. My trust is in the Lord. I will rejoice and be glad of your mercy. Into your hands, O Lord, I commend my spirit. Let your face shine upon your servant. Save me in your kindness. You hide them in the shelter of your presence from the plottings of men.
The Lord be with you.
With your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John.
Glory to you, Lord.
The crowd said to Jesus, "What sign can you do that we may see and believe in you? What can you do? Our ancestors ate manna in the desert, as it is written. He gave them bread from heaven to eat." So Jesus said to them, "Amen, amen, I say to you, it was not Moses who gave the bread from heaven. My Father gives you the true bread from heaven. For the bread of God is that which comes down from heaven and gives life to the world." So they said to Jesus, "Sir, give us this bread always." Jesus said to them, "I am the bread of life. Whoever comes to me will never hunger, and whoever believes in me will never thirst." The Gospel of the Lord. Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Morning again. Yesterday, Father Angels asked a question, and it's a very good question for all of us to reflect again. What do we seek God for? What do we seek God for? Most of the time, we seek God for our petitions. We ask the Lord to do this for us, and this is why we should ask for so. But the right order to come before when we come to God, it's different. It's based on the four steps. Go to God. First, we seek God for worship. Second, to give thanks. And third, to offer the sacrifices. And last, for petitions. And that's the right order when we come to God. To worship, to give thanks, to offer the sacrifice and petitions. But most of the time, we reverse the order. We ask for the petitions first, give us first, and then we will give you some sacrifices, to give some donations, to do something, and our belief in you, give you thanks and worship you. So we reverse that order. But God always asks us to follow the right order of worship God, give thanks, offer the sacrifices, and then petitions. And in today the gospel, follow from yesterday gospel, people still seek God, Jesus, for something else. They do not seek Jesus as God. They seek Jesus for bread. They hunger for some kind of bread. And they talk about that, well, our ancestor was given bread from heaven and to Moses. But Jesus pointed out that you look for the secondary, for the bread. You forgot about seeking the one who gave you the bread. And Jesus corrected all the crowd that you have to seek the one who gives you the bread. And he said that, "I am the bread of life." So when we come to Jesus, we're not just seeking for something, a favor from him or something for our need, but we have to look at the one who gave us all the needs, the one who gave us life eternal. So when we come to the Savior, the Eucharist, the Mass, we're not looking for some nourishment only. That's a secondary. We look for God, the one who gives us all things we need, the nourishments for our souls and eternal life. So let us right the wrong order. Go to God for worship, to give thanks, to offer the sacrifice and our petition. If we follow that order, if we worship God constantly with sincerity of heart, if we give thanks to God and offer the sacrifices, the petitions will be given before even we ask for that. Because Jesus promised that he knows what we need. The Father knows what we need. God the Father did to the people of Israel in the desert. He gave them manna to eat in the desert and water to drink to quench their thirst and guide them along the way for 40 years, provided 40 years of food on a journey.
God is going to do the same with us if we go to God first, seek Him first, and then all things will be given unto us. Amen. Now let us put our trust in the Lord, who knows everything what we need and present our petitions.
For the church, as the body of Christ in the world, may God bless her with purity and unity. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For our elected leaders, may God grant them fortitude to rise above all that divides them. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those suffering religious or ethnic persecution, may God protect them from all harm and prejudice. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those in our community who are newly baptized, may God give them strength to live out their baptismal promises. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those who have died, may they find a place in heaven at the eternal banquet of the Lord. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the repose of the souls of Richard Polymus, Carolyn DeMarchi, and Margaret Gore, for whom we offer this Mass, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
And for our own special intentions in the silence of our hearts. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
And we continue to offer the whole world to the Lord, and those especially working in the medical field, the nurses, the doctors, responders, and all these people who care for the sick, and for all of us, our family too, members, so that we always stay with God and be connected and be protected. And we offer all these prayers and petitions to the Father through the intercession of our Blessed Virgin Mary as we pray.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through the goodness we have received the bread we offer you, food of the earth and work of human hands, it will become for us the bread of life.
Blessed be God forever.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through the goodness we have received the wine we offer you, fruit of the vine, work of human hands, it will become our spiritual dream.
Blessed be God forever.
Pray, my brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands, for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church.
Receive, O Lord, we pray, these offerings of your exultant church, and as you have given her cause for such great gladness, grant also that the gifts we bring may bear fruit in perpetual happiness to Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It
it is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation at all times, to acclaim you, O Lord, but in this time above all, to love you yet more gloriously. When Christ our Passover has been sacrificed, he never ceases to offer himself for us, but defends us and ever pleads our cause before you. He is a sacrificial victim who dies no more, the lamb once slain who lives forever. Therefore, overcome with paschal joy, every land, every people exalting your praise, and even the heavenly powers with the angelic hosts sing together the unending hymn of your glory as they acclaim,
Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending thou your Spirit upon them like a dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. The mystery of faith. When we eat this bread and drink this cup, we proclaim your death, O Lord, until you come again. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have called us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis our Pope, Kevin our Bishop, the Assistant Bishop Timothy and Thomas, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy, welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the Blessed Apostles, Saint Kilian, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you, through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever.
Amen.
At the same
we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of thy mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to the apostles, "Peace, I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of the Church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us.
Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us.
Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Grant us peace. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
My dear brothers and sisters, now I ask all of you, along with me, to pray the act of spiritual communion, to invite, to ask the Lord to come into our souls, into our hearts, into our home, in a special way, as we always are able to enter into the souls that desire him. So let us pray together. My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the most holy sacrament. I love you above all things, and I desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot at this moment receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. I embrace you as if you were already there, and unite myself wholly to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. Amen. Let us pray. Look, we come.
kindness upon your people, O Lord, and grant, we pray, that those you will please to renew by eternal mysteries may attain in their flesh the incorruptible glory of the resurrection. To Christ our Lord.
Amen.
And now we pray the prayer to Saint Michael.
Saint Michael, the archangel, defend us in battle. Be our protection against the wickedness and snares of the devil. May God rebuke him, we humbly pray, and do thou, Prince of the heavenly host, by the power of God, cast into hell Satan and all the evil spirits who prowl about the world, seeking the ruins of souls. Amen.
Any announcements? Have a wonderful day. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
And may Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and